Hello, welcome to the weekly technical analysis review here at XM.com. I'm Rafiq Bahajan, currency analyst, and today's Monday, March 19th, 2018. The pairs we're going to be looking at this week are dollar yen, the euro dollar, the pound dollar, and the Kiwi dollar. Starting with a dollar yen, we can see the pair is looking fairly neutral at the moment. The RSI is below 50, pointing to downside risk, but it has flatlined. If you look at the stochastic oscillators, though, we can see the percentage K line is attempting to cross above its percentage D line, and we can see some upside momentum currently with prices just above the 106 level. We can see though that in the past few weeks the 20-day moving average has been acting as a strong resistance barrier, though early in the month they did briefly climb above it. They failed to close above it though, and then we saw a downside reversal falling back below the 20-day moving average and below the 261.8% Fibonacci retracement of the up leg from 110.83 to 113.74. So that's the key resistance at the moment, around the 106.10 area. A break above that and also a break above the 20-day moving average currently at 106.40 could clear the way towards the 107 handle. We would need to see a successful challenge of the 107 barrier for more convincing upside drive for the pair. We can see it's still some way off the 50-day moving average, currently around 107.90. To the downside, we do have strong support coming from the 105.50 region, which was a strong support area earlier in February as well, and then we've got that 16-month low of 105.24. So a major support area there. A breach of that support though could open the ways towards the 104 handle, and then that would reiterate the medium-term bearish outlook. Let's move on to euro dollar now. We can see the euro dollar is also looking fairly neutral. We can see it did slip below the 50-day moving average in the past few days, and is currently trading around the top of the Ichimoku cloud. So we do see the medium-term outlook weakening and potentially moving into more a neutral trend in the medium run. In the short term, though, it is lacking direction as well, with the potential support coming from around 1.2255. That has been a previous support area in the past. Below that, we've got the 1.22 handle. And then a drop below 1.22 would deepen any downside moves and potentially drive it below the Ichimoku cloud. We can see the bottom of the cloud currently around 1.2120. On the upside, the next resistance will likely come from around 1.2320, which is the currently where the 50-day moving average is, and then not too far above that we've got 1.2355, where the Kijun Sen line is, and then we've got those tops from earlier this month and in February, 1.2412 and 1.2445 as potential resistance areas. Let's turn to pound dollar now, because pound dollar is looking rather bullish in the short term. We can see RSI ticking upwards. So it still remains some distance from the 70 overbought level, so there's still it's got plenty of room to run before the current upside momentum would potentially run out of steam. If this strong momentum continues, we could see resistance coming from the 23.6% Fibonacci retracement of the up leg from 1.3302 to 1.4344. Before then, we could potentially see resistance from 1.4069. That was a top from late February, and then we've got another top from February of 1.4144 if it breaks above 1.41, and then got the potential resistance at around 1.4270, it would need to break clear that region before challenging the 1.5 year high of 1.4344 we saw at the end of January. To the downside, we are seeing immediate support coming from the 50-day moving average, as well as the 38.2% Fibonacci retracement at around 1.3945. If it was to breach that support level, we could then see the 50% Fibonacci retracement at around 1.3820 acting as the next support, and then below that we've got the 1.37 handle, the 61.8% Fibonacci retracement. In the medium term though, we can see the MACD has turned positive in the past few days, and its prices are also rising further a bit above the 50-day moving average, pointing to a slight strengthening of the bullish outlook in the medium term, which had been at risk of turning neutral. And our final pair for the day, we've got the Kiwi dollar. We can see it's neutral in the short term with a slight risk to the downside. The stochastics, though, are attempting to turn higher, having reached oversold levels, so it's too early to confirm an upside reversal. The 38.2% Fibonacci retracement of the upper leg from 0.6780 to 0.7436 is acting as a short-term support at around 0.7185. That's also where the 200-day moving average is currently converging at, pointing to an important support level there. Below that, we could then see the next support coming from the 50% Fibonacci retracement at around 0.7110. A drop below that level would increase downside risks, potentially driving towards the 61.8% Fibonacci retracement at around 0.7030. But if prices were to reverse higher, the next key resistance would be the 23.6% Fibonacci at around 0.7280. That's just below the 50-day moving average. And then further up, we do have that top from earlier this month at around 0.7354. That's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and have a great day.